Hi guys, this is Simeon here on this nice and sunny day. How are you guys doing?
I'm learning him to teach how to ride a bike.
You're teaching Danny how to ride the bike? That's good. Well, I'm glad you tuned in. Chances are, no matter where you are at, that you have a lot of time on your hands. And YouTube views have gone up, Netflix views have gone up, all that stuff. And right now is really such a good time to do something very useful with your time. I just wanted to give you some Highland cattle goodness today with Lucky, our little bottle-fed calf. If I can find her here, I've been combing her hair lately just to give her a little extra love and help her to take care of herself. She doesn't have a mommy who can lick her fur. Let's see here if I can make it brighter. Here you go. Hey, Lucky. Hey, girl.
She's got some fat.
Yeah, she's fluffy. I've been brushing her hair. Let's open up here.
Is that a cat?
Hey, Lucky. Let me set this here. Lucky, come here, girl. Come here, girl. She's still a little baby.
But she's still very cute.
I've been brushing her fur a lot just to keep her clean.
Well, she likes you a lot. Why does she even like something on her?
Why she like it? Because she's a calf and she still likes sucking. She would still like to get milk. But we are not giving her any milk.
You just like pretending you're giving her milk, so she's just like without water. Instead of getting milk, she's sucking out your blood.
I need to watch out for my wedding ring so she doesn't suck that one. It's kind of embarrassing that she hasn't had milk in months, yet she is still.
But she's big enough to eat it.
Oh yeah, that's all she gets. She doesn't get milk.
Yeah. It's even nicer when she
Yeah.
I know. Well,
they're starting to lose their winter fur here very soon. Yeah, they get a lot of the long hair they drop in the winter time, and they get that in the summer. They have a thinner. Look, here's still her bright spot with the brighter fur. It's funny.
The cheeks are watching the camera. Hi, Danny. Hi, Isaac. He's here brushing Lucky's fur. Danny, no, Danny, be careful. The cheeks are here.
Yeah, you see your little horns here? They're coming.
Look at all that.
I know she does.
Hi.
Hey, girl.
Ew! That's so gross. How come you don't care, Papa?
How come I don't care?
Yeah, he's a cat.
So?
Cat.
Yeah, here you can see her horns coming in. Look, it's kind of very embarrassing.
Look at that gross. Tails
and stuff.
Huh? Look at them. They have huge horns.
Papa, is that Dozer? Or is that Dozer
Kelvin?
Papa.
Hmm? That's Dozer, right? That's Dozer, okay. Papa.
You can go out there. No, he was in a fight and the horn broke off. Yeah, it was bleeding a little bit. But that's what happens sometimes.
What do you mean a fight?
She's begging me
to
give her milk again.
She's like, "Can you give me milk or I'll bite your fingers off?"
Is that a bull or a cow, Papa? Is that a bull or a
That's
cow?
A bull.
Yeah, but was he fighting with a person?
No, he was fighting with another bull. Was fighting with his brother. Do you fight with your brother sometimes?
Papa, how come you don't care? Papa.
Sorry, I can't wash my hands.
But that's still gross. That's her spit, Papa, on you. Papa, that's her spit on you.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Why is she sucking on your fingers, Papa?
It's like a pacifier for her.
You're a pacifier. You're a baby thing. You like sucking on my puppy fingers.
Oh, do you like itching your head here? Hey, Ellie, go out with him that way. Go out that way with him. Anyways, guys, I wanted to give you a heads up. Right now, in this time where so many people are stuck at home, we're wanting to make our book available to as many as possible. So it's 80% off now till April 30th. Just go to our store at swedishhomestead.com and get yourself a copy. It's an awesome book to help you prepare for your life after the quarantine, I would say. It's The Self-Sufficient Homestead, a practical guide to create extra revenue from the homestead. And I highly want to encourage you to spend this time for something like that. Prepare yourself for a future life, for homesteading, for growing your own food to be less vulnerable. Well, Henry, that bull is looking at you. I think he wants a fight.
No.
No? What's he wanting to do? What's he wanting to do?
Sumo.
Sumo fight? Oh my goodness. Look at on the other side here. What's there? Look at that. The last chickens. Before we're gonna sell them. Wow, look at my pants. Oh my gosh, I'm full of her spit everywhere here. Gosh, lucky girl.
Your head's so big.
Does she swallow your hair?
My hair?
On your finger.
No.
But your ring is gone.
It's on the other hand. Really it's right here.
You really scared me.
Yeah.
I thought... Hey, Paul, get away! Oh, he was fighting.
Yeah, Lucky's being bullied.
Lucky
is at the very lowest spot on the ladder of hierarchy here in our little herd. Ah, they can drink their own spit. Anyway, gotta close the gate here. Hey, Hey, what are you guys doing during this time where you have to stay home? Did you lose your job or are you at home spending time with your family? I'm really curious to hear and know. And I'm sure if you need help, you know, there may be people close by to you or people even that can reply on the comments that can give you advice on what to do. I actually use this time a lot to read the Bible, to pray. I'm writing a book right now that I hope I'll be able to publish at some point. It's about being freed from oppression in your life, and I hope to really share that at some point. You know, this is really impacting us more than it would have normally, because we are planning on moving to Austria in the middle of May. It's a very exciting step that we are still hoping to be able to take as planned, but right now that's just very uncertain. The borders are all closed. You know, if the move was right now, it wouldn't be possible, and it's quite challenging. I mean, we have food here. We are on a beautiful farm. We can walk here, even though we are restricted. But the thing is, you know, we have started to sell off most of the animals. A lot of our things in our house are in boxes already, and now, you know, there's really a situation where nobody knows. So in a sense, we're all affected by this, and you know, I wish we had already done the move and we would be right now at the place where we would be planting seeds and growing our own food already, starting up the new season. But you know, this too will pass, and we are very excited that we still have very healthy food and a good supply, and hope and pray that we can still do our move. And again, if you have some $4 or $5 left over and you want a good read and spend your time wisely, I really recommend our book that's normally $30. Go to SwedishHomestead.com. I think it's very important, you know, to take advantage of the time that we have. And there are also lots of other great videos out there. I mean, I heard from Justin Rhodes that so many people are buying seeds, so many people are ordering chicks, and so many people want to know from him how to grow their own food, and that's great. You know, go to our YouTube channel, go to his, go to many other good YouTube channels out there that explain to you how to grow your own food, and learn this and start it on your balcony, in your apartment, on your property, in your backyard, wherever. So hope that inspires you a little bit. I'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.